Oh, bother. Whatever am I to do now, Clive?
About what?
I've two dresses that need stitching, but I haven't got a scrap of linen. Those girls' rags are so threadbare. It's a wonder they don't fall to pieces. And we most certainly cannot have that. A certain amount of decorum must be maintained, even here at the hideaway. You wouldn't want the poor things going without decent clothes now, would you?
Of course not. What can I do to help?
Oh, aren't you a dear? You see, I've paid for two bolts of cloth from the drapers in Northreach, blue and red. But they don't deliver, not to places that aren't on the map anyway, so I'll need someone to take this receipt and collect them.
And you'd have this someone be me?
I would. And don't let them fob you off with anything less than what I paid for. One bolt of blue and one of red. I expect them both.
And the Cookies Guard haven't been seen.
To ride from here. Let's go. Run like the wind. Yeah! Come on.
Faster.
They give us new clothes.
Our man in Dalimil mentioned the Cookies Guard haven't been seen there.
What can I do for you? And a fine, fine day to you.
Them pilchards nice and chilled.
Look at this place.
Let's hope the draper has Hortense's cloth.
Might I interest you in some swan's down? Perhaps some seersucker or herringbone?
Just some linen. Two bolts. Already paid for in full.
Apologies, my lord, but your items aren't here. They were due to arrive on a caravan from Bucklad, but there's been little traffic on the road these past few days. My mother thinks it might be bandits, but she always thinks it's bandits.
It usually is. So I assume the caravan will be coming from the south?
Yes, hopefully carrying all manner of spice and sundries. Wait, you aren't thinking of...
Going to find it. That's exactly what I'm thinking.
Oh. Well then, be safe.
Yeah!
isn't going to be easy. Rest well. I know I will.
She meant nothing by it, I swear.
Who's gonna buy my wares now? State your animals left them in.
But they hardly damage us all.
Is there something wrong?
If you're a bandit come to steal my stuff, you're gonna be sorely disappointed. And all thanks to this fool.
But it was you who stepped into my path.
Only after that feather brain trampled me. I demand recompense, be it in coin or the items you carry. Refuse, and I shall report you to the garrison and see you hanged.
These goods are expected in Northreach. I mean, they're not mine to give away.
You wouldn't happen to be on your way from Boklad, would you?
I am, but did someone from the market send you? Please, you have to help me. I can pay whatever you ask.
So the fool has protection. And coin, too. Sorry, friend, but we'll be the ones taking it. Oi! Killer! It's time to collect!
I told you not to call me that. And we'd have already collected if you hadn't insisted we'd put on this little act.
Bandits!
As I told one of your customers, it usually is. Let's get this over with.
I'll deal with the bird lover. You take the handsome one, killer.
Stop calling me that!
All right. You made your point. Killing my ass.
Did he hurt you?
No, thankfully. He seemed intent on letting the bandit do his dirty work for him. And he would have succeeded had the great lender not sent you. My shipment is safe, and my livelihood with it. You must allow me to reward you.
We can speak of that once you're safe in Northreach. I'll accompany you there.
So, you and my mother were right. It is always bandits.
And were it not for the kindness of our free sword here, you'd be buying your order back from them at twice the price. Now, if you don't mind, I have a pressing appointment at the Vale before my return to Boklad. Farewell.
Oh, I almost forgot. I suppose you'd be wanting your linen. You'll be happy to know both bolts arrived safely along with the rest of the delivery. I've also added a few extra lengths of our finest fabrics to the bundle. Free of charge.
Are you sure?
My mother would insist. It's the least we can do for the man who saved our shipment.
How's that done then? Now it's back to Hortense with it.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Oh, there aren't any more of them.
Thank you.
without him at their gate.
What are you after? Much obliged. There you go. Thanks very much. Fare thee well.
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here have to look after each other.
Don't get surrounded. time.
Clive, sorry again for sending you all that way. But you did get my order, didn't you?
Don't worry. I have it. I believe this will more than satisfy your needs.
Let's see here. One bolt of red, one bolt of blue. What's this? I don't recall ordering any silk or velvet or... Is this gold work? Krieger's ghost. If that devil of a draper expects me to pay for these...
You needn't worry on that score, Hortense. They were a gift. For services rendered. I can always return them if you like.
Oh, there's no need to be hasty now, Clive. I'm sure I can put all three to good use. Speaking of which one's most to your liking?
I don't know. This one, I suppose.
I've a mind to give a piece to Jill. Did you know she's quite the little seamstress?
I know needlecraft was amongst her lessons at the castle.
Her lessons? Oh, that's right. The two of you were raised together in Rosalith, weren't you?
Not quite together, but... When my father put down the uprising in the Northern Territories, Jill was taken as a ward to ensure that her father, the Silvermane, would keep the peace.
She's an honest-to-goodness princess, then, isn't she? I could tell, you know. Some people just have that air about them. Not many round here, mind. I'd offer to sew her something that might better suit her station. But she'd most likely turn me down, as she always does. Tell me not to waste the fabric when it's better used on the children.
Don't take it the wrong way. She certainly seems to be attached to the last outfit you made her.
Oh, sometimes I think she never takes it off.
Well, perhaps she'll make something for herself with your gift. Either way, I'm sure she won't turn it down.
We'll see, I suppose.
Lady Hortense said she'd give... dresses soon. Said they'd be made of linen.
What do you need? What's that for you, dear? Should last you a good while.
Sid, I know that when we came to the hideaway, we chose to let go of our past in order that we might focus on our future.
We did.
Nonetheless, I was wondering if... Well, I know you are from Rosaria, and I'm in need of someone with intimate knowledge of those lands. Apparently, the duchy is home to all manner of curative herbs found nowhere else in the realm. Among them is a flower called a Morganbeard that increases the potency of lesser medicines.
I can't say that I've had much practice healing. My youth was spent in the Bailey.
A shame. You see, the hideaway relies heavily upon medicines procured from afar. And when those shipments are late, well, it's our sick who suffer. If we could find this flower and learn to grow it here, we might save many lives. However, as you are well aware, Imperial occupation has rendered the roads unsafe for those like me, untrained in the military arts. Now, I'm not asking the busiest man in the hideaway to drop everything and make the journey for me, but if you happen to be in the duchy on other business...
Tell me of these Morganbeards, then.
But of course, if my old tomes are to be believed, the flowers are bright yellow and as large as goblin's eyes. Oh, and they grow in the marshes of Sorrowise. If I am to propagate them here in the backyard, I will require several samples, preferably of blooms which have already gone to seed. And before I forget, I do seem to recall learning in the course of my research that their odor has the tendency to attract unsavory creatures. Nothing you cannot handle, though, I'm sure.
Let us know if you find any rotten planks. I'll see about replacing them. All right, Sid.
Knowledge is yours. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. I have quite the find for you today. You wish to study the tomes?
Man and Dalimil mentioned that Kutka's guard haven't been seen there of late.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Come to claim your just desserts. All yours. Here you are. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Clive! Quick look. Always something in there.
Here for another of my lectures.
What is it that you wish to learn? One must understand one's place in the world. Here's the latest information I have. The state of the realm is ever-changing, Clive.
Thank you for sticking with us.
Those of us who are still here have to look after each other.
See if they're damp enough for Morgan Beards. Bright yellow. These are our Morgan beards, all right. Well, there's something familiar about this scent. It reminds me of home. Hopefully this will be enough.
Thank you.
'Tis rare that we see you so often in the backyard, Cid. What brings you to the gardens?
I found your flowers.
Yes, yes, wonderful. These are almost identical to the plates in my tome. Did you have any trouble locating them?
Finding them was the easy part, but it's odd. They remind me of my childhood somehow. I don't remember these flowers specifically, but you must have grown them in the castle garden. If the petals are meant to improve the effectiveness of medicines, it's possible that the court physicians grew them for the tinctures and treatments they made my brother.
If the ducal healers were convinced of their properties, that is all the more reason to begin growing our own supply here. Oh, allow me to use some of the flowers you brought me to make something that might aid you on your travels. I need only a moment to extract the essence from the petals. And here we are. A phial of pure Morganbeard extract. A single drop added to any one of your restoratives will increase its potency. At least I hope it will.
Man and Delamore mentioned the cookies guard.
I've done what I can, but the rest is up to you. You need to start taking better care of yourself. Understood. And thank you. The curse has spread. Make sure she rests.
If it hurts, you can tell me, you know. I'll understand.
I can bear it.
But you shouldn't have to. Not anymore.
This isn't just your struggle, Clive. It's ours. And when we see how hard you fight, it inspires us to do the same. Or would you rather we left you to save the world all on your own?
No. That's not... Ignore me.
Clive, where are you?
In here.
What's wrong?
Rosaria's under attack.
What?
This isn't the Dalmechian army we're talking about. It's the men of the Rock from Drake's Fang. Hugo Kupka's private guard. There is in hell in Rosalith. Trying to batter down the castle gates.
Looking for me.
Seems that way. Reckon old Hugo has finally worked out who Cid really is.
Then this is just another trap.
It's a trap, all right. The daddy of all fucking traps.
I'm going to Rosalith.
You're not serious. That's exactly what he wants you to do, Clive.
Look, I don't know why Kupka harbors such a grudge against Cid, but as long as it's left to fester, our world will never know peace. He has dragged the rest of Storm into this pointless war just to find me. Besides which, I'm not about to stand and watch while my home gets ground into the dirt. Hugo Kupka must die.
I've lost enough friends to that man already. I don't want to lose any more. So let's go and kill the bastard.
I'm coming too. After all, we're in this together.
All right. I should probably speak to Otto before leaving. We need to know what we're getting ourselves into.